If you don't know you exist, then how did you say I had a good sleep after waking up?
State of mind.
No. Mind is not there in deep sleep. You know deep inside, without the mind, you know exist. You exist without having a mind. Without the mind and body and the world, I exist is your deep-rooted intuitive knowledge. That's why I get a good sleep. And this knowledge doesn't require a mind or a body. Intuitive knowledge, I exist.
This ahankar exists in all these states. That is why we say, I got a good sleep.
No. That ahankara is a thought. That means I thought. That has gone to sukshma rupa. No, the sukshma rupa, there is no experience, because there is nothing to experience. See, I exist, that's why the difference is that I exist doesn't depend on any object to exist. It's an intuitive knowledge. And I exist without a body, without a mind or without intellect is our intuitive knowledge, and that is Brahman. Which doesn't require the world or body or mind for existence. The existence depends on that. That is your nature. Now there's no body, there's no mind, there's no intellect, but I exist.
Who says that I had a deep sleep?
The one who had deep sleep. No. The one who had a deep sleep, who had intuitive knowledge. That's why I told, knowledge is of two types. Objective knowledge. Intuitive knowledge. The intuitive knowledge is beyond these two. That person doesn't require an object to know. He says, I had a good sleep. And one who says that is continuing all the three states. All the three states are false.
Atma says, because consciousness is Atma.
Atma is not a state. Atma. So, Miss Jagrati is false. Miss Sapna is false. Miss Sushupti is false. Only one who is reality is there, who is running through all these, he is called Atma or Brahman. Okay? Who doesn't go undergo change? Because that doesn't undergo change. You know Miss Jagrati is coming and going, Miss Sapna is coming and going, Miss Sushupti is coming and going. These are three different personalities, different time frames, different space, different body, but still, you say I, which has not changed. 10 years back, I was in Bombay. Yes, my dear sir, you are in Bombay. Did you have the same body? No. Did you have the same mind? No. Did you have the same intellect? No. Then are you very in Bombay? Yes. Who was in Bombay? The I was there all the time, which is unchanging. 10 years back, 20 years back, now in waking state, dreaming state, deep sleep state, that I which doesn't change is there in the background all the time, unchanging, amidst the changing Jagrati, Swapna, Sushupti, waking, dreaming, deep sleep state, coma, samadhi, all those states, the I which is unchanging is like a thread which is there, which has never changed.
That is conscious.
I'll tell you. Difference I'll tell you. Right? Is that clear? There is something in us which has never changed. Which never changes. No point of time. That's why I say 20 years back I was in Mysore. Body has changed, mind has changed, intellect has changed. So I woke up in the morning, I had a dream, I had deep sleep, body has changed, mind has changed, intellect has changed, but the I has not changed. Right? So this unchanging I is called awareness. Brahman. Okay? Now that unchanging I, because it's not changing, it is not in time or not in space. Not in time, not in space. It is not one particular I. For me there's I, you there's no I. No, there's only one I. The person in America also says I. But when anybody says I, they are referring to the unchanging I, but always confusing with the body, mind and intellect. The confusion is with respect to body, mind and intellect. But reference is to the unchanging. Are you getting what I'm saying? Whenever I say I am changing, I has not changed. Not only me, you say I, he says I. Everybody when they are referring to I, they are referring to unchanging I. And always we confuse with the changing body, mind and intellect. You have to be clear what you are referring and what you are confusing. The confusion is body, mind and intellect. The reference is unchanging. Deep inside you know that you are not changed. Right? That unchanging I, which is awareness, okay, that is called Parabrahma or Supreme Reality. It never changes. There's no time, no space. And that unchanging I is same for all of us, the whole of universe. That is called Parabrahma. But that unchanging I appears in our body-mind complex as a reflection. So I feel the body is alive, right? The aliveness is there in the body. I feel I am there in the body. The body is alive. The body is alive because of the unchanging I. This aliveness is called consciousness. I am feeling is there. Okay? The I am feeling goes up and down. In deep sleep, I am feeling goes. But I never changes. The I is the witness or the sakshi. That is the Brahman, that is Supreme Reality. So there is unchanging I, which is Supreme Reality. The changing consciousness in me. So suppose I give some anesthesia, external awareness will go. I will become unconscious. Okay? In deep sleep, the I am feeling goes. But the consciousness will be there in some form. And after death, the body will go. The consciousness will go. The consciousness comes and goes, but I doesn't come and go. The consciousness is called Chidabhasa. Okay? So that consciousness makes the body alive, feel alive. Oh, I am alive. Okay? And the thought comes. I am the body. That I am the body thought is called Jiva. That I am the body thought is called Jiva, which is a completely misunderstanding. The wrong understanding, because the body itself is continuously changing. No point of time you can say this is my body, because the body is continuously changing. In a day you are changing the body many times, because body is changing. In dream state you already change the body. Dream many dreams you change many body many times. So, but there's an illusion remains that I am the body. Okay, that's called Jiva. That I am feeling, which is there in me, aliveness is there in me, is called Chidabhasa or reflected consciousness. The reflected consciousness also changes, but I never changes. Whenever say I was in Bombay, in reality I refer to an unchanging I, but I always confuse with the changing body-mind complex and Bombay also. Bombay also is changed. So Vedanta is telling you, Vedanta is teaching us to distinguish between what is changing, what is not changing. Be very clear what is changing in your life and what is not changing in your life. And what is not changing, what is changing in your life is not you. What is changing in your life is not at all you. Your dream character is not you. Your waking state body is not there in deep sleep state. That's not you. Okay? So, drop what is changing and realize what is unchanging. That is called Brahman. No, I will go into Samadhi and find out. No, sir. It has to be found out only through discrimination, only through Jnana. Mukti can happen only through clear understanding, not because I went into Samadhi. Because Samadhi is also another state. Miss Jagriti, Miss Swapna, Miss Sushuti, Miss Samadhi. So by Samadhi, no, Mukti is not result of Samadhi. Okay?
What is Turiya, sir?
Turiya is the I. The I which is unchanging. Okay, everything else is changing. It's, Turiya means beyond three. What is beyond three? Waking state, dream state, deep sleep state. Waking state comes and goes, dream state comes and goes, deep sleep state comes and goes. But something is not coming and going, because of that these are able to change. That something which is not coming and going is called I, which is real I. Now please don't start thinking that real I is also, there is a thought. Real I is not thought. Real I is pure silence, absolute stillness. Okay, that is Brahman, Supreme Reality. Brahman cannot be explained through any words. You can only, with reference to waking, dreaming, deep sleep, you can say Turiya. You can give only relative reference. But absolutely you cannot point out Brahman, because it is not an object. Brahman is not a state. Not a samadhi also, not even samadhi. Nirvikalpa samadhi, savikalpa samadhi, none of these is Brahman. Okay, Brahman is not a state. Samadhi is a mental state, like waking, dreaming, deep sleep. So what is beyond all mental states, beyond all thoughts, is Brahman, which is self, which is unchanging, which is unchanging reality, and that reality is myself.
That you can call it as Chaitanya.
That's unchanging, it's Pradnana. Pradnana, okay? It's called Chaitanya. And that's absolute reality. And we cannot express in words, thoughts. But we can only give elimination process. I gave the elimination process, Miss Jagati, Miss Swapna, Miss Sushupti. The fight between them I showed you. And I made you understand that none of this is you. You cannot say I am Miss Jagati because the body is changing. Miss Swapna will deny that. Miss Sushupti will say your body is not there. Right? Also they teach us a lot, Miss Jagati, Miss Swapna, Miss Sushupti. Miss Jagati says I am the body. I am the mind, I am the intellect, all my relationships are these. Miss Swapna will come and say, no, this is my world, this is a different world. Okay? Your morning waking body is not real. See, this is real body. So she is another real body. Oh, your relationship in the morning, they're all outdated. See, my relationships are here. This is with Miss Swapna's days. Miss Sushupti, that means Miss Swapna denies your waking state experience. Waking state world, waking state body, waking state mind is denied by Miss Swapna. Miss Sushupti says, the world is not there, the body is not there, relationships are not there, intellect is not there. My nature is peace. Actually, Miss Sushupti is very, very close to Atma. Because this...
Turiasis.
Huh?
What?
Turiasis. So, deep sleep, he experienced the bliss of Atma closest. That's why all of us want to go to deep sleep. In deep sleep, all appearances, world, everything disappears. So, Miss Jagati, Miss Swapna, Miss Sushupti, together they are teaching us the world is unreal, the body is unreal, the mind is unreal, the intellect is unreal. Only reality is the Atma, which is self, which is Brahman, which is you. I'll tell you that. Okay? So his question is, what is Turiyatita? See, the Turiyatita is only nomenclature. I'll tell you why is nomenclature. Turiya is the absolute reality. Okay? Yato vacho nivartate, no words can reach that. Whatever you tell about absolute reality is false. But we can only point out by denying what is the source. Just now I denied by Jagati Swapna. No, wait a minute. I'm saying the awareness is a word. So all those things are, I can say from my waking state. Beyond my waking state, there is Turiya. Beyond my dreaming state, there is Turiya. Beyond my deep sleep, it is Turiya. That means absolute I am giving in terms of relative. Absolute I am giving in terms of relative. It is not fair for the absolute. Okay? So, absolute, telling the absolute in terms of the relative is not fair. Right? So, that's why its word called Turiya Atita is given. Somebody who has realized this, okay? Who is no longer referring to Turiya with respect to waking, dreaming, deep sleep state. He has become a Brahmadnani, he has become a Jivan Mukta, he is called Turiya. For other people, it's only reference. Turiya is beyond.
The choiceless
awareness is Sakshi. The witness is called choiceless awareness. Choiceless awareness is nothing but Sakshi.
Turiya is emptiness.
No, see, Turiya
is emptiness.
Turiya is there are no objects. When you no objects, it's awareness. Okay? In the sense, emptiness means no objects are there, no thoughts are there.
What is samadhi?
Samadhi, what is samadhi? Samadhi means samadhi word is consists of samadhi. There are two words. Samadhi. Dhi means intellect. Right? The intellect becomes completely balanced. It's called samadhi. Now intellect is unbalanced actually. Intellect is unbalanced by the idea that I am the body, I am the mind, I am the intellect. Okay? Intellect is imbalanced. Now intellect is completely balanced when through jnana, I am not the body, I am not the mind, I am the intellect. There's a pure stillness. Now there is a intellect is directly under the influence of Sakshi, the witness. So that state is Samadhi. In other words, Samadhi means the intellect being in one with the intellect working under the reality, which is Brahman. It says, okay, now the samadhi which yogis speak of, samadhi which is normally spoken of, savikalpa, nirvikalpa, savidarka, nirvidarka, savichara, sananda, sasmita, they are obtained by making the mind silent. Okay, which is actually more of suppressing the mind. That's called manolaya. So that state of samadhi is temporary. It will go and come back. The mind becomes silent, the intellect becomes still and comes back. There's no thoughts there. So that's a temporary state, that's not a state of jnana. It's almost like another deep sleep state. Now Vedantic samadhi is coming through proper jnana, proper discrimination. What is not self, you are eliminated. Then you are establishing what is self, Brahman. So that samadhi is not reversible. Whereas samadhi which you obtain through breathing practice, through mantra, japa, all these things are reversible. You enter into samadhi and come back, enter into samadhi and come back. Whereas a jnana samadhi, clear discrimination, anatma, anatma viveka, okay, nitya, anitya viveka, that samadhi is not reversible because the intellect is completely purified. So then in that state, you are in reality with your eyes open or not open. Whether sleeping or dreaming or waking state, you are in samadhi. The samadhi means reality, absolute reality.
Samadhi and turiya is one and the same.
Turiya is referring to what? Chaitanya, consciousness. Samadhi means going there and coming back. Okay, but in jnana samadhi or realized state, samadhi and turiya means one same thing in realization state. And that realization is called mano nasha. Ajnana has gone. Whereas any state which gives you temporary samadhi is called mano laya, suppression. So let us close for the day with the thought. Nanu nanembudu nanalla ideha mana buddhi nanalla sachidanandatma shivananu nane shivoham 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 asatoma sadgamaya tamasoma jyotirgamaya mrityorma amrutam gamaya. Om shanti shanti shanti. Lokah samasta sukino bhavantu. Lokah samasta sukino bhavantu. Lokah samasta sukino bhavantu. Harihi Om Shri Gurubhyo Namaha. Harihi Om.